Hello students, this lesson we will learn about Parajambal's solving and how the theory is applied into practice in CAT. So I'll take questions from CAT 2017-18-19, the latest pattern, and run you through the thought process in details, so that whenever you find difficulty when you are practicing at home, you can always go back to this video and time and time again run through the thought process which I have used. So I will explicitly mention that as well, apart from the solution. All right, so let's get started with the first question. You need to find the correct order 1 2 3 4 4 3 2 1 and type in the answer. That is what this question is all about, to form a coherent paragraph. Statement number one: such a belief in the harmony of nature requires a purpose, presumably imposed by the goodness and wisdom of a deity. Statement number two: these parts all fit together into an integrated, well-ordered system that was created by design. Statement number three: historically, the notion of a balance of nature is part observational, part metaphysical, and not scientific in any way. Statement number four: it is an example of an ancient belief system called teleology, the notion that what we call nature has a predetermined destiny associated with its component parts. Right? So when you read it, the first thing which should happen in your mind: what are we talking about? Subject identification. Right? Definitely nature. Yes? Balance of nature. Yes? Okay. And something like teleology. Right? That nature has destiny with parts. So subject identification is the first thing. Then you can look for links. Got it? That is how you think. Now let me take you to another slide where we will discuss the solution. So now look at how do you find links. Okay? So what is the fundamental theme? Is it about nature? Anything about nature? No. It is mostly about the notion of balance of nature. Right? You know? It's about balance of nature. Okay. And you see, it's statement three talks about historically. So that might be the beginning. Also look at such a belief. Which belief? Now such phrases, starting part. See, they create thoughts in your mind. Link identification means understanding kahan se kya jud sakta hai, where can we connect. Right? So such a belief. Which belief? These parts. Which parts? Just think like that. Right? To learn to think. So first, then historically. Okay, so this looks like the beginning of the discussion, historically. Then the notion of balance of nature, right? The part in red. Yes, that is the overall theme. Okay. Then it is an example of, alright, we are giving an example, okay, of something, right? So what is it? See, have a look here. It is an example. What is an example? Is that it mentioned somewhere else? So this is how you think and you try to build links and then eventually reach to a logical end to the question. So these things, these parts, right, connecting parts or the overall theme, these should get highlighted in your mind while you are reading. You cannot just keep reading the passage over and over again and think, how do I connect? All right, these are examples. Don't just look at the solution. Try to understand the logic, the thinking way that I'm telling you, because in real time, when you have 1 to 2 minutes, if this thing is clear, this thought process is clear, you will be able to perform better than solving many, many, many questions and trying to learn the answers. That is not what helps a lot. All right. So let me go to the solution part now in terms of trying to get to an answer here. So the first thing, historically, so that might be the chronological first one. The notion of balance is part observational, part metaphysical, not scientific. Okay. So we are talking about the notion. Notion means belief, right? Of balance in nature. So three is the starting sentence. So what should come next? All right. Now, when we look at the others, we see 4-2 is a link. Why? Because you see, the notion associated with its component parts. Getting this? Associated with its component parts. And then 2 starts with these parts. There is a continuity connect. Associated with the component parts. 4 ends with that. Right? And 2 starts with these parts integrate into this kind of a thing. Right? Got it? So 4-2 is connected. So can I connect 3-4-2 now? Let me think about it. So 3 is historically it's like that, And it is an example of teleology. What is an example? The notion of balance of nature. It is referring to the notion of balance of nature. Do you get the point now? What is it referring to? It is referring to what is given in statement 3. So now we have been able to connect and understand 3, 4 and 2 being linked. Got it? And one, anyways, it's an outlier. It's a sentence, such a belief. What belief? The belief that was being discussed till now, right? Such a belief in harmony of nature that requires something by goodness and wisdom of deity. So it's a general kind of outlier type of sentence that it's all by God, it's by goodness, right? So it's a general one, not directly related to the description of the notion of balance, but giving a general comment or a remark or something on the belief. So first, the three parts which get connected on the belief, they come first, right? So 3, 4, 2, and then we go to the last one, which is 1, right? Which is a general statement. Understand, general statements usually, if there's a logic being discussed, the logical connecting sentences, they come together and the general statement comes in the end. So many things we discussed here. How you should look for the subject first, look for chronology, how parts of the sentence which can connect, they should get connected in your mind, right? And then you should start building that connection and eventually look for a logical end. Got it? So what is the thought process again? Look for the starting sentence, that is the subject identification, link identification, look at the parts which might connect in the sentences and try to connect and eventually look for a logical end. So that is the logic behind this topic. All right. Okay. So I hope this you will be revising this over and over again to try to understand how we should be thinking. Got it? Okay. So let's come to the next example. This one, again, this question is same. You have to arrange the sentences to form a paragraph. The first sentence, conceptualizations of women's time as contrary to clock time and clock time as synonymous with economic rationalism are two of the deleterious results of this representation. See, okay, this representation. Now, see, my mind is already catching. While dichotomies of men's time, women's time, clock changing and caring time can be analytically used, this article argues that everyday practices incorporate a multiplicity of time and both men and women can engage in these multiple times. Okay, again, see, the last one, the last sentence was such a belief is this, and this article argues, so possibly this might be the ending. Now I'm just trying to build a pattern in my mind. I'm not saying it would be, but my mind while reading, it anticipates. Anticipation is a very important skill here. I hope you're getting my point. Let's go to number 3. When the everyday practices of soul fathers, working soul fathers and working soul mothers are carefully examined to explore conceptualization of gendered time, it is found that caring time is more focused on the clock than generally theorized. So what type of sentence is this? This sentence is talking about gendered time, right? Conceptualizations. Okay. The first one was talking about women's time versus clock time. Okay. And the second one was talking about why these times are this, the article argues. Okay. See, I'm categorizing sentences as I read in my mind. Okay. Number 4, clock time has been consistently represented in feminist literature as a masculine artifact representative of time is money perspective. Now, the moment I come to this sentence, I said, okay, we are talking about feminist literature, right? And clock time is this, women's time, we will do some contrary work, gender time, etc. Eventually, we will say that all this is fine, but there can be multiple times. So I, for one, by keeping this simple logic in my mind, have already kind of generated a thought in my mind that it has to start with 4 and end with 2, because 4 is introducing what it is, the feminist literature. So see, have a look at the solution now. So feminist literature, this is the broad part, right? Right, where is this article coming? Where is this thought of discussion coming from? It's coming from feminist literature, right? So 4 comes first. And as I said, the article argues about all these times together while this is done, this argues. So that is kind of a concluding logical end to this entire discussion. So 4 comes in the beginning, 2 comes in the end. Now with this kind of mindset, right, now I just need to look for continuity, right? Okay, so if you go to 1, deleterious results of this representation, harmful results of this representation, which representation are you talking about? That is mentioned in 4. Masculine artifact representative of time is money perspective. So 4 gets connected with 1. Getting it? I hope you're getting this. 4 is getting connected with 1. right? And then comes 3, got it? And eventually we come to 2. So 4, 1, 3, 2 becomes the correct answer. So while, see how important anticipation is while reading, if you are anticipating, automatically by the time you go to thinking that what should be the final order, you already have some things in your mind and then you reach to a final answer. Either you do or you leave and move to the next question. Getting it? So these are CAT latest questions, CAT 2019 questions. I thought I'll do a run through on these to make you understand that the thought process itself is a skill for a CAT aspirant, right? Every year I cross approximately 80 marks in the verbal section, and in that time limit, that's a good score. Reason being, just that the fundamental is very clear. It's not that I'm practicing lots of questions, I'm teaching you guys, but the fundamental is so strong, the thought process is so clear that I can run it through the questions and more often than not get it correct, right? So I want you to go through this over and over again and understand it's not about getting inputs from multiple sources, it's about understanding the clear CAT thought process to application, right? And that's why I, as I said, I took CAT questions, the latest ones, as examples. Okay, let's go to the next one. Okay, so one more question we are taking here. All right, if you look at this one, first sentence, living things, animals and plants typically exhibit correlational structure. Second, adaptive behavior depends on cognitive economy, treating objects as equivalent. Third, the information we receive from our senses, from the world, typically has structure and order, and it is not arbitrary. Fourth, to categorize an object means to consider it equivalent to other things in that category and different from some along some salient dimension from things that are not. Okay, right. So what are we talking here? We are talking about living things, animals and not. We are talking about behavior. There is something about cognitive economy, right? Behavior in economy, that is, and treating objects as equivalent. All these things have been introduced in two. Two appears to me as a very, very, very strong theme kind of a statement, right? That is what comes to my mind, okay? Apart from that, I also get an idea that the categorization of objects and two talking about objects, these objects talk is being done in two and four while reading itself, that kind of hint I'm trying to take, right? And then correlational structure, which is given in one, right? And structure is also given in three, right? See, I'm just trying to get some hints, okay, that what can be the connecting parameters here. So structure here, structure there, three and one. I also see talk about objects in two, right? And I see that kind of a similar categorize an object thing here given in four, right? So, okay, let's check out the solution now, right? So if you see the general one, which introduces all things here, cognitive economy, we are talking about economy and the behavior thing, that entire, the introduction that is given in two, and see the object-object connection comes in two and four. So what does categorizing an object mean? That comes in four. Now in the end part, if you see this bolded portion, right, different from some other salient, from salient dimension form, it means you are looking for that when you are considering objects being equivalent and different, then there might be some things which might be different and you are trying to focus on those things, right? Okay, so how do you focus on those things, right? So three talks about that. The information we receive from our senses, that typically has structure and that's not arbitrary, and that is where the salient dimension thing gets connected. And one finally ends with that different living things exhibit such kind of a relational structure. So if you look at this particular example, I hope you got the point that see how structure got connected, how object-object got connected, then you thought about which should be a theme which is introducing multiple things, and then the flow got into creation. Clear? Okay, so I hope you are understanding the examples now. I'll now go a bit fast with some more examples. This one from CAT 2018. The woodlands canopy receives most of the sunlight that falls on the trees. This one you'll find in the Bee Factory blog as well in the next couple of months. So let me explain. The wooden canopy receives most of the sunlight that falls on the trees. Swifts do not confine themselves to woodlands, but hunt wherever there are insects in the air. With their streamlined bodies, swifts are agile flyers, ideally adapted to twisting and turning through the air as they chase flying insects, the creatures that form their staple diet. And the last one talks about hundreds of thousands of insects fly in the sunshine up above the canopy, some falling prey to swifts and swallows. Alright, so this is the one which we have read. Now let's directly go to the solution part. Now I'm going through a bit fast. You can because you can revisit, try and understand them again. So if you see, what are we talking about? We are talking about the woodlands canopy, right? And again, you see the canopy connect is here, right? And the insect connect is here. See, these things happen. So first thing, this is what I call subgroup formation. Getting it? If you see here, 2 is talking about insects. So if you find a subgroup, then it's only about trying to find out connection. Order, which will come first, which will come next, you know, and that is something which you can try. And if you are able to reach up to this, chances of getting wrong becomes very less. So insects 3 and 2 are connected, right? And the canopy 1 and 4 are connected. See, these are all CAT 18-19 questions. So this kind of connection link, this is something that you should look for. I hope this thing is understood. Best logic of flow in those links, that is something which is the kaun pehle aayega, kaun baad mein aayega, in mein, that is something which you need to read and understand the logical sequence. Getting it? And that can vary from question to question, and you need to apply your logic there. Okay, so let's have a look here. 1, it's about woodlands canopy and the sunlight that falls. 4, and many insects fly in the sunshine. Again, see, sunlight falling and sunshine above the canopy. So 1 and 4, it's a very logical connection, right? And now the point number 4 talks about swifts and swallows, and then 3 and 2 describes it, right? Why 3 first, then 2? Because 3 is talking about the properties of swifts and how they eat these insects, and 2 talks about the logical end. It says not just the woodlands, but they hunt wherever there are insects in the air. Are you getting my point? The point here is that this particular flow, 1-4 is fine. You talked about there's a canopy. 4 says, yes, there are swifts and swallows eating insects. 3 then says, how do they eat insects, etc. And 2 says, not just in the canopy, but other places also. So that is the logical end, taking it to the, connecting it to the other part. Right? That not just here, but also somewhere else. So that is a standalone or a further connecting line, and hence it comes in the end. So I hope you are understanding these connecting logic. Let's come to the next one. The implication of retelling of Indian stories hence takes on a new meaning in modern India. 2, the stories we tell reflect the world around us. 3, we cannot but help but retell the stories that we value. After all, they are never quite right for us in our time. 4, and even if we manage to get them quite right, they are only right for us. Other people living around us will have different reasons for telling similar stories. 5, as soon as we capture the story, the world we are trying to capture has changed. Now, I'll do this fast using the framework that we have learned. Just have a look at this one, right? First, which are the ones talking about the world? 2 and 5 are talking about the world. Got it? And last, we come to what is being talked about? India. Getting it? So, I already have a hint that 2, 5 should start and 1 might end. Right? Another way to think, stories we tell and we capture a story. Telling and capturing is given in 2-5. Right? Now see, 3-4 and 1, they are talking about retelling stories. So first you should talk about telling stories and then go to retelling stories. Right? So let me run through the answer now. Now I guess you are getting the points here. The connecting, world connection. 2-5 starts with the world and telling of stories. Right? So when you capture the story, that comes in 5. Right? Then 3, but we cannot help but retell. Now look at 3 and 4 connection. Never quite right for us. 3 says they are never quite right, and 4 says, and even if we manage to get them quite right. So never quite right should come first, and then should come that even if we manage to get them quite right. So 3 and 4 is connected, and eventually again see a general statement connecting it to the other irrelevant or generalistic statements or sentences connecting to some futuristic or further part, they usually come in the end. So many CAT examples I've shown you now. I hope you are understanding this. So one is talking about it takes a new meaning in modern India. That's a general statement, and hence is also there. So it comes in the end, right? So the answer is 2-5-3-4-1. Now there will be many such questions, right? Remember, the fundamental that you should understand from me is that the thought process should be the same. Look for the starting sentence, look for the link connectives, and eventually look for a logical end to the discussion. Revise this video every time, every month before CAT, every time you get stuck in para jumbles, and your concepts would come back to you, right? And try to keep applying them stronger with more focus and more concentration every time. Thank you.